Wait, I'm in the armed forces.
You can make your statements at headquarters.
I want to call my parents.
You can do that at headquarters.
We have classes.
What's this all about?
They're here?
Yes, sir.
How many?
Two for the moment.
Any trouble?
I don't know. No, sir.
I mean, they resist arrest.
No.
You're not certain.
They did not resist arrest, no.
Witnesses?
The caretaker at the university.
Evidence?
Just the leaflets at present.
Circumstances?
They were seen dropping them from the first landing onto the main hall.
And?
And they were arrested.
By the janitor.
But citizens arrest, yes, but this is what they were passing around. Students, the German people look to us to break the National Socialist terror through the power of the spirit.
What?
The power of the spirit. We have a check on their Aryan ancestors.
They look more Aryan than Frederick the Great.
Nevertheless.
This wouldn't be another embarrassing mistake, would it, Mahler?
Their father, Adolf Robert Scholl, has been arrested on at least one occasion for expressing himself in unflattering terms about the field.
What did he say?
Something to do with livestock.
Ah. Well, we're only investigating the individuals in question, Mahler. I'm not interested in the prison records of their relatives.
Sir, I've been
such a moment. I only had this job a week. Do we already need supervision?
Of course not, sir. I'm just here to assist.
And write reports.
Sir?
Berlin likes reports. Do you like Berlin reports, Mahler? It's good to have an affinity for that sort of thing.
Reports?
Paperwork, Mahler. I was promoted because I've been a good policeman for 25 years. I know my job.
That's a relief. Bavarian Gestapo needs
what?
Tightening up.
Why don't you bring the girl first?
She's... they're odd.
Odd?
Well, Schmidt says...
Schmidt?
The janitor?
Ah.
He said they did it quite openly, that they weren't trying to hide.
Then they confess.
Not at all. They deny everything, and they're... But they seem unusually calm, sir.
Well, I want to take a look at them.
I assure you, I've ever...
I want to take a look at them. Speaking. Which newspaper? Put it through. Yes, yes, Heil Hitler. Yes, an arrest. Ministers of Justice and Propaganda have not authorized a statement at the moment. Pending investigation, yes. We've no doubts as to the press's loyalty to the Reich, Herrmeyer. As you know, we release information on all treason cases. Look, there hasn't been a hell of a lot going on lately. We'll keep you posted. Certainly. Yes. Heil. Name?
Sophie Scholl.
Age? 21. Occupation?
Student at the University of Munich.
What do you study?
Biology and philosophy.
I thought girls went for literature courses.
Oh, I read a lot of
what?
Things, whatever's allowed, available.
Love stories and such.
Yes.
Do you know what you're accused of?
Something about leaflets?
You are suspected of co-authoring and distributing a set of pamphlets hostile in the extreme to the Führer of the Reich and the German war effort.
Goodness.
These pamphlets are nationally anonymous and titled The White Rose.
I know nothing about it, sir.
What were you doing in school today? You have no classes according to your schedule here.
We decided to go home tonight, to Ulm. We had to let some friends know. Do you think we'll make the 5 o'clock train, sir? If not, I have to call home.
You suddenly decided to go home? Why?
Oh, Mother, you know how it is.
And your entire luggage consists of an empty suitcase.
What?
When you were arrested, you were carrying an empty suitcase.
Oh, for the laundry.
The laundry.
Yes, Mother does our laundry and we pick it up from her. Hans never washes his own clothes. Disgusting!
Yes. Well, Sophie, is it?
Yes, sir. Sophia Magdalene Scholl.
Sophie. Do you know the contents of the pamphlets in question?
I've seen them around. Everybody has, so I have an idea.
And you know what they say?
Well, I believe they call the Führer a charlatan, and well, a mass murderer.
That's not what I...
And a gangster, and
there's no subhuman. There's no need to be
questions. Since you asked.
I'm talking about the political implications about the ideas expressed.
Politics?
I don't know anything about politics.
No. Church bells next door? I love them.
Give me a headache.
I've seen Mathilde Schwarzkopf.
Pardon?
Hans. You wanted to see Mathilde Schwarzkopf.
Mathilde Schwarzkopf.
Yes, our youth group leader a few years ago.
Ever you?
Of course. Both my brother and I were group leaders. Although she's no better than she should be, if you ask me, she went over to the boys' camp after hours.
Yes, well,
everybody knows Mathilde Schwarzkopf in Ulm.
I imagine they do,
it's
but...
not as if she's pretty or anything. She has an altogether alarming underbite. Of course, she's a blonde, so that's a plus.
Yes.
So but... there I am, stuck at home for the whole weekend while Hans visits with old Horseface over there. I have better things to do with my life. Lots of homework, the romantic poets this term, you know, and
naturally. Would you step out for a moment?
Outside?
Yes. Bauer? Escort Fräulein Scholl to the anteroom for a moment. How are you doing with the boy?
He's uncommonly eager to talk, sir, about Aristotle and glass painting and theodicy. What in the hell is theodicy?
Whatever it is, it's got to be better than the laundry and the Mathilde Schwarzkopf.
Beg pardon, sir?
We do not seem to be on a fruitful path here, Bauer.
Sir, we have a material witness.
I'm afraid we're going to need a hell of a lot more than that. These are young Aryan individuals of some standing and visibility. The boy was in the army. Come in.
I looked up theodicy for Aristotle. It means vindication of divine providence in the view of the existence of evil.
Some other time, Bauer.
The janitor, the Schmidt individual,
saw them. He looked up when he saw the leaflets falling, and he saw them.
He looked up into the light, and he thinks he saw them. And there is a 3,000 mark reward that went into Herr Schmidt's pocket, any harm.
There's enough evidence.
North Africa, lost. Over 300,000 dead at Stalingrad. That boy has been on the Russian front. People are angry.
It's precisely because of Stalingrad Berlin wants these pamphlets stopped. The people's morale.
The people's morale will not be improved, I assure you. If we wrongfully arrest a war veteran, a medic, no less, look at these records and a Girl Scout on the word of an Herr Schmidt.
Girl Scout?
Both Scholls were leading members of the Hitler Youth. You people are in too much of a hurry. You don't read reports. I want to send them home.
Sir, Berlin.
This is Munich, Herr Mahler. I am in charge here.
The circulation of the pamphlets has been extensive. They've reached Austria, sir. As a representative of the Reich Ministry of Justice, I must impress upon you, we need an arrest.
But we've had arrests on this case already, Mahler. 5. In the past 2 months, to be precise. Last time, it was 2 octogenarian spinsters from Hamburg who turned out to be related to General Rommel, one claiming to be the Grand Duchess Anastasia.
At this point, sir, even they would do.
Those are not methods I approve.
New ideas require new methods, Herr Wong.
I am a police investigator. I don't know anything about ideas. I don't like investigations to blow up in my face. Bring me the Scholl boy. I won't be needing you, Mahler. Name?
Hans Scholl.
Age?
25.
Occupation?
Sergeant in the 2nd Student Medical Company, Munich University.
Do you know why you're here?
Some misunderstanding about printing and politics?
Does the name of the White Rose mean anything to you?
Not really, no.
On the day of your arrest, that is today, Thursday, February 18th, 1943, Jakob Schmidt, caretaker at the university, states that he saw you and your sister, Sophia, scatter several hundred sheets of paper from the first landing of the central staircase into the main hall. These things contain highly radical material and are signed the White Rose. Does that refresh your memory?
There must be some mistake. Herr Schmidt is notoriously nearsighted.
You served as a medic in France and Russia?
I'm a medical student. I'm a very bad shot.
It seems your father did the same in World War I.
We're a traditional family.
And you have a brother on the Eastern Front.
Werner, yes. Good soldier, decorated several times.
And your father has been the mayor of several small towns.
Yes, my father is...
What?
Very civically minded.
I've heard. The paper you tore up when you were arrested.
Somebody in the crowd pushed it in my hand, and I thought it might be incriminating. What with that red rose business and all.
White.
Pardon?
White rose.
Oh, I would have thought that it would be red, being leftist propaganda.
It's not exactly leftist.
No?
There's a lot of twaddle about God in those leaflets.
God, in this day and age.
But Molly tells me you're somewhat interested in God.
Interested?
You've taken a course in theodicy or some such thing.
Oh, it was part of a required course in philosophy.
Do you believe in God?
It's rather an excessive idea, don't you think?
The paper you tore up when you were arrested, we put it back together again. It contains defeatist ideas regarding war and the Führer's military capabilities. It proposes Franklin Delano Roosevelt as an ideal leader.
Well, then it must have been one of those red rose people put it in my hand.
White.
What?
It's the White Rose.
Right.
I understand you were planning to go to Ulm today.
Yes, home for the weekend. Pick up some clean clothes. My sister doesn't do any of her own laundry. It's disgraceful.
Yes, well.
Actually, seeing a girl there.
Would that be a Mathilde Schwarzkopf?
You know Mathilde?
What? I don't know Mathilde. Probably. I'd like you to step outside for a moment. Bauer will get you some coffee or what passes for it these days. Bauer? See that Scholl here has some coffee or water, whatever he needs.
Coffee, sir?
Yes, Bauer. You know. Coffee. From beans. Where's that report on the house search?
The search is still in progress, sir. So far, nothing much.
Nothing much. I'll give you all another 15 minutes and I'm sending them home. This is a ridiculous waste of time. Let's help. Oh, hello, dear. No, nothing much. Actually, I've been discussing the laundry and an unattractive young woman of apparently easy virtue called Mathilde Schwarzkopf. From home. Tonight? No, 8 o'clock should work. At the Mueller's. That frightened child always bangs out the Moonlight Sonata after dinner. Certainly. I like music. Very well. Fine. 8 o'clock. Have you taken Bismarck today? Nonsense! He's never bitten anybody in his life! He just doesn't like redheaded people, that's all. Oh, by the way, I can't find my pocket watch, the good one. Well, I did. I put it away for safety, and I just can't find it, that's all. Would you? Good. Fine. Just tell you. No? Nothing new. Yes. Garden gate. I'll fix it over the weekend. It isn't safe. I'll talk to you later. No, I have an important meeting.
We've arrested several other students.
Careful! You don't want another student riot on our hands like last month's. Students tend to get nervous when their classmates are arrested or radicalized.
That wouldn't be repeated, sir. The riot police.
These kids are interested in being home for dinner, getting their laundry done by their mother, I might add. And visiting a woman with an unimpressive jawline. If not fundamentally dim, they're at best unimaginative. They didn't write those silly pamphlets.
You consider those pamphlets harmless, sir?
Oh, for heaven's sake. Listen to the tone of those things. The rantings of some religious fanatic or a crackpot academic.
They've been found everywhere. Churches, schools, factories, public transportation, theaters.
Who's going to read them? People don't read. People go to the movies. Nobody reads. I'm sending them home.
Come in.
It's from the investigator searching the school's quarters, sir. Here's the report.
Does not look like it.
The Allies!
an honest, intelligent National Socialist?
Can't be.
And why not?
Because if he's intelligent and a Nazi, he's not honest. If he's honest and a Nazi, he's not intelligent. And if he's intelligent and honest,
he's not a Nazi!
Not so loud!
Open the goddamn door!
Oh, I can't.
Christ, we heard halfway down the hallway.
What's
that? One of the most beautiful things ever invented.
Fine, but what is it?
A printer. A duplicating machine.
Where'd you get it?
I stole it.
What do you want it for?
I thought I'd use it in place of my bicycle. To print things, of course.
What things?
Alex, would you like some wine?
I'll go get another glass.
We're out. Get one from Franz and downstairs.
Hi, Hans. On Fitch a banquet shall I meanly fly, the one of all my band that would not die.
This is hardly the time for Byron.
Oh, I don't know. It may be just the time.
We know what we think. Isn't that enough?
No.
Convictions don't change just because you can't want them.
But they do, little by little. Nothing is time-proof, especially convictions.
It's a dangerous choice.
Goes with life. Even Adam and Eve had to choose to become human.
Warden, they were human before. They weren't counting on more.
Oh, for heaven's sake. Are we going to sit around arguing about how many angels go through the eye of a needle?
Camels, Billy, camels.
What?
It's camels for needles, angels for pins.
Philosophy course. To choice and mortality.
Present.
Joel, telephone, female.
Fine.
Women never call me. Why is that?
You're just too passionate, man, Billy. They're frightened.
What? I am never.
That's not we hear from Matilda Schmatzkow.
What? Never in a million years.
Professor Ermengarde for that matter.
Ermengarde? She looks like stolen.
Never mind them, Billy. They're just jealous because you are a gentleman and they are pigs. Here we go, Alex.
Oink, oink. Oh, flesh, flesh. How art thou, fishify?
I have a toast.
Ooh, a toast.
It's not me, then he has a toast.
Well, let's hear it for God's sake.
Lady, gentlemen, and swine. I give you William Shakespeare.
Goethe.
Dante.
Schiller.
Mine.
Shelley.
Thomas Mann.
What?
Frank Sinatra.
The printed word.
Thank you.
Waiting.
Are you hungry? We brought...
No.
What's the matter? No letter from Fritz?
I don't write Fritz anymore.
I'm glad.
Somebody has been passing around a leaflet. Like, whoever they are, it's very interesting. They call themselves the White Rose.
Really?
Sounds like a perfume advertisement.
The Spartan Code of Law is based on the dangerous principle that human beings are to be considered means and not ends, thereby destroying the foundations of natural law and morality.
That's Schiller, isn't it?
I found the same passage underlined in your book.
I couldn't just go on talking about it, making jokes because we feel helpless.
I don't like to feel helpless. I want to take them on.
You mean we go at them, just like that?
Not you, just us.
Why not me?
It's dangerous.
For you too.
Oh, we're men.
Don't worry, I'll carry smelling salts.
I don't want you in this.
Too late.
Stay out of it, Sophie.
I can't.
You mean you won't?
Can't. I can't just knuckle under.
Hubris.
Nobody asked you.
Fine.
So stay out of this.
Right.
Aren't you afraid, Sophie?
I'm terrified. But the worst of it is, I'm so scared, I think if I don't do something right now, I'll start to go along with them.
Nonsense.
It isn't. We're no better than anybody else. Fear is the great mind killer.
We could be found out at any moment.
And they won't catch us. We're smarter. We're quicker. We're younger. And we're right. They can't catch us.
I won't let you.
You used to take me everywhere with you.
Don't remind me. Me too, me too.
Hansel.
Don't call me Hansel in front of people.
Oh, Alex isn't people.
Oh, fine. What do we tell Mom and Dad? I'm supposed to be looking after you.
Tell them we love them.
Don't get flippant with me, so.
Then don't tell me what to do.
Hey, hey.
Anybody talking to you?
Nope.
Do the others know?
No, and they never will.
What the hell do you think
are
you're doing?
Are you out of your minds?
We have a Christoph Brooks, sir.
What else? What time is it? I don't have to watch.
Past midnight, sir. We've also picked up a Wilhelm Graf. Belongs to all sorts of Catholic groups.
Yes, well, religious types aren't dangerous.
There's Bishop von Gallen, sir. We can't arrest him and we can't shut him up. For the moment.
You have great faith in the system, don't you, Mahler?
Lack of faith is unpatriotic, sir. And unsafe. Sir?
I always thought faith and safety mutually exclusive. Never mind. What about the other arrests?
More of the same. Nobody knows anything. Everybody likes the show of such a good family, so German, they couldn't possibly. One girl keeps referring us to a Professor Huber, who would apparently be more than glad to attest to their good character.
The theodicy professor.
He's very popular with a certain element. We're gonna bring him in.
What else do we have on Probst?
24 years old, medical student, no previous arrests, married, 3 children.
Great! At least Frau Probst knows her duty to the fatherland. Do you have children, Mahler?
No, sir.
I do.
The Groff boy, he's also a member of the armed forces at the second student company at the university. Now the girl.
Leave the girl to me.
Certainly, sir. I just wonder.
There's nothing to wonder about. Whatever her brother may have done, I'm certain she's not involved. She knows nothing. She's quite an ordinary girl.
She seems ordinary to you, sir.
Charlotte Corday doesn't exactly come to mind.
Like that, but she's so calm. Does that seem ordinary to you, sir?
That could be because she has nothing to worry about.
Could be. Would there be anything else, sir?
Yes. Interesting as those postage stamps may be, I'm afraid they won't quite do the job.
I don't understand, sir.
Handwriting analysis? Stamps? If you'll forgive me, it sounds like something out of a magazine my housemaid would read. This is the army we're dealing with, about a handful of Bolsheviks. I really need something more conclusive.
The graffiti on the city walls last month. That was then, too. We have men out looking for the paint and stencils.
Would that satisfy you?
Me, Mahler. It has nothing to do with me. It's proper procedure. Considering the people involved, if this gets out, it should be an open and shut case, or it should be quietly dismissed.
Contacts in Hamburg, Salzburg, Linz, and Vienna.
Augsburg and Stuttgart this week too. The response is everywhere.
How much response? We've friends at three other universities already reproducing and passing on leaflets.
That scum will think this is a nationwide movement. When we get to the resistance.
The resistance focused on hiding when somebody wrote a few pamphlets.
People are outraged at Stalingrad. All those dead boys, they have families. Men wearing party badges have been attacked in the streets. It's only a matter of time.
I don't know.
Chris, if you don't want to.
Of course I want to. I'm going to be a doctor. I'll be taking an oath about saving lives. What else can I do?
Perhaps nothing. You have a wife and two kids.
Nothing is not an option.
We'll stop them, Chris. The entire youth of Germany will rise and send that rabble back to the sewer it crawled out of.
Are we swashbuckling? Is that what we're doing?
Come on, Chris. Nothing like a little swashbuckling to brighten things up, I always say.
Aren't you ever afraid, Alex?
Well, yes, but they'll never know when, no if, we get caught.
God's on our side. We can't get caught.
Oh, Billy, do you think of this as some sort of 12th century crusade?
I am a practicing Catholic. I believe every article of the faith. I cannot even pretend to support National Socialism.
Alex?
Oh, I believe in, I don't know, the Ninth Symphony, the Sistine Chapel, Stradivarius.
Frank Sinatra.
I'm taking 2000 to Frankfurt tomorrow.
Careful on the train.
Always.
What time?
9.
Don't talk to anybody. That way nobody will remember you.
Oh, nobody notices me anyway.
Impossible. You always wear a flower in your hair.
For good luck.
Flowers bring good luck.
It's a well-known fact.
Sophie, your little world is governed by the most mysterious laws.
My world is enormous.
Sophie, would you like to...
Curfew and blackout in 5 minutes.
I've got to go. I need to come back for sulfur.
And I'm going back to Innsbruck tomorrow morning, so I'll take my match.
You don't have to.
I want to. Remember, on the train, put them in an overhead rack far away from where you're sitting.
Right.
And put them next to some pig with a party bag.
And look stupid.
Last time I looked so stupid, the SA tried to recruit me.
See you in a week or so. God willing.
Come along, Billy.
Right,
bye. Bye.
Don't put them all in the same mailbox.
And look carefully all around before you slip them in.
Careful. Funny word for us to use.
And remember the code.
Right. The course of the Beethoven 9th.
Whistle.
What?
It's got to be whistle. You hear that and you get the hell out. It means they're close.
Christ, I hope you never have to do this.
Well, what should we do? Night is young.
We could. We've got some more printing to do.
What?
No.
Just another couple thousand.
For all.
I want to go out by the river. Cool a bottle of wine in the water. Talk to girls about verses and sonatas and jazz and the moon and all that.
Yes. Well, I'd like to go dancing, but we can't do that anymore.
Why not?
There isn't enough time.
We'll be here all night.
I can't stand it when men whine.
Damn. Sophie, go to the shelter. We'll take care of this.
But for God's sake, got a lot to do. Come on.
The typewriter, the mimeograph machine, paper, plus the paints and stencils. There's enough evidence to incriminate him.
As long as it's not ours, Mahler.
The paint and stencils and mimeograph machine can be traced to an Alexander Schmorl, a close friend of the Schultz, and
a medic at the Second Student Company.
Why, yes. We have been out looking for him now. Sir, I think we've uncovered a large network of agent provocateurs and underground agitators, most likely in the pay of foreign powers. They must have connections everywhere.
In a way, I hope you're right, Mahler, because if this turns to be the work of a handful of college students...
Well, then the case will have to be closed immediately.
I quite agree. Get the little bastards off to the front where they belong and out of here so we can do our job.
Oh, no, no, sir, quite the contrary. You see, our job is to handle things quickly. That's all. Quickly, efficiently. Surely you understand, so as to not look too terribly foolish.
Well, they're not my problem. I'm signing papers for their immediate transfer to the appropriate military authorities.
Like the previous Munich Gestapo, the army has a history of leniency with their own.
Bring me that girl here.
Yes, sir.
Now, Mahler, the civil authorities have no jurisdiction over the members of the armed forces to risk friction between the high command and the Reich Ministry of Justice at this time would be extremely problematic.
I don't think Berlin wants military tribunals, sir.
Herr Mahler, I am a police investigator. I don't deal in politics, and I don't handle army matters. I have cases of sabotage, arson, war profiteering, air raid looting, and attempted assassination on my hands. Troubled waters stir up scum. I'm after scum. I don't have time to deal with adolescents wailing about the power of the spirit, and I don't clean house for the Wehrmacht. I want these people out of here.
And the girl, sir?
I believe I've made myself very clear about the girl. I don't need you, Heil Hitler. Several of your connections with other universities have been arrested.
Connections? I have school friends. We're not political.
We're at war. That statement is not acceptable.
I don't believe in war.
That statement can put you in prison for life.
Should I lie to you?
You've been lying to me for 2 days.
I don't know what you mean.
What exactly is your relationship to Christoph Probst, Alexander Schmorl, and Wilhelm Grabe?
We study together. We have parties.
Printing parties?
I don't know what you mean.
Do you know what an accusation of high treason means? What is your relationship to Professor Huber?
Huber?
Kurt Huber, yes.
Oh, I took his course. Introduction to Philosophy.
Did your brother take his course as well?
He may have.
You both took his course together. Very recently.
I've forgotten.
As a matter of fact, all of you have taken that course at one time or another.
He's good.
But a few moments ago, you had trouble remembering his name.
I don't know what you mean.
That seems to be your favorite statement.
I'm sorry.
Just how good a professor is he? Is he the one who fed you all his camp?
Hey, don't... What?
What is his particular attraction? Why does he have so many students?
He's an extremely patriotic man. These are hard times. He's adamant about the preservation of German honor.
What's his opinion on the Führer?
He never mentions the Führer in connection with German honor. It's an introductory course, you know. The Greeks and all that. Plato, Socrates.
17th century.
Some.
Spinoza, for instance.
Spinoza.
Spinoza. The Jew.
Oh, Professor Huber told us we were never to read him.
It seems he spent the better part of a week telling you not to read him. And Sigmund Freud.
He was explaining how dangerous they are.
We know this professor has had little soirees to which his favorite pupils were invited and where certain topics were discussed.
Heard of them.
I assume your brother and his friends haven't either?
We don't go to a lot of parties.
But you said you did.
What?
You said you had parties together.
just a moment ago.
I
what? With your friends. You said you had parties with your friends.
Oh, but not with the
professor, I see.
No.
Not even to discuss the preservation of German honor, whatever that may mean.
You don't know what it means?
Depends on whose terms.
Honor has no terms. It's the one thing in life that's absolute.
Then surely you can explain to me what it is.
I wouldn't presume to explain to a government official what German honor is or should be.
I wouldn't find it presumptuous. I find it interesting. Please.
I don't know the difference between personal honor and national honor. Do you?
What about boy Sophie? Are you in love? Are you in love, Sophie? What about your parents? Are you fond of them?
Fond. I wouldn't say fond. Fond is a sentimental notion.
Think very carefully. Could you not have been influenced by the wrong sort of people? Let us say a subversive element in our universities and misled into doing something, the implications of which you did not understand. Students, especially young women, are often impressionable, easily confused. This professor of yours could turn out to be the only one responsible.
I don't understand. But as you say, I'm a girl, and girls are easily confused.
Damn it! Try to turn the tables on me, Sophie. I'm an old hand at this.
I don't think so.
What?
I'd say you're rather new at this, and you don't like it.
What in hell do you not want to live?
Passionately.
Passion is for the opera, Sophie, not for everyday life.
Too bad for everyday life.
Look, it's time you went back to your
self. That word doesn't come easily to you. You must be in the wrong business.
Serving Germany is not a business, it's a privilege.
Oh, you love Germany?
Well, certainly I.
Because I love Germany passionately.
Bauer? Get me Mahler right away.
Yes, sir.
I'll be calling you again.
I expect you will.
Good day.
I wish it were.
Damn it. I want the complete dossier for this case, and Colonel Hauser and Dorn on the phone immediately.
Sir, the Reich Ministries of Justice and High Command have temporarily agreed to suspend restrictions on civil jurisdiction over the military.
At this time of night?
They've been discharged and turned over to us, the Ministry of Justice. They're already out of uniform now, sir.
On whose orders?
Berlin.
Then Berlin can have them.
They would like it handled in Munich, sir.
Do they also want us to tell the nation and the world at large that the members of the armed forces of the Third Reich and the Hitler Youth together have produced an element which calls for the downfall of this government? Because I warn you, the BBC is going to have a field day with this.
That's precisely.
This is an army scandal. They want to put it on us, don't you see?
There will be no scandal, sir.
When the
public? There will be no public, sir.
Do you imagine we can cover this up?
There is an official press blackout on the case. The People's Court is traveling in from Berlin tonight. They will be here within 24 hours. The trial is set for Monday morning at 10. Dr. Roland Freisler is presiding. It will go very quickly.
You've been very busy, Mahler.
Thank you, sir. May we expect the indictments first thing tomorrow?
The nature of the indictments will depend upon the information collected, and they will be handed over when all the evidence is in my hands to my satisfaction. Which means that as all allegations seem largely circumstantial at the moment and are not corroborated except by this Herr Schmidt, I'm going to need something along the lines of a confession.
Of what?
A confession, Mahler, to hand to the public at some point should the press in an overzealous attempt to uphold the system commit an indiscretion.
Will there be anything else, sir?
Yes, Mahler. I want all action concerning this case to be initiated or approved by me before it is carried out. I want interrogation to proceed carefully and all information to pass through my desk before it is forwarded anywhere else.
Under no circumstances should there be any contact with news agencies of any kind, or with other departments of the government, for that matter, until I decide it's appropriate. That will be all.
What difference will it make?